staying in the fight. I call it tunnel vision.
Tunnel vision. I like that.
And focus. Tunnel vision.
You know, Bruce Finch, that was a flash knockdown. That was a... I don't think you were ever down Terry Norris. You were in your last great years. I mean, those fights, I don't think you were ever down hurt.
No, I mean, when Terry Norris talked me that, because I'm knocked down. People got to understand, I'm knocked down. Depending on what it hit you. You go down. Your body just shuts down. You just go down. You don't feel it. It's not pain. But when you hit like up here, equilibrium, and you go down, because you know you're in trouble. Now you know you better straighten things up. Yeah.
Yeah. What do you think about Canelo Alvarez? Mexican press Iñaki is asking that you express very, very positive remarks about Canelo. What do you think about him? What would you like to say about Canelo?
Well, I've watched this young man many, many years ago when Oscar told me about him. And I just saw him develop. I saw him grow. And I saw him change. I saw him develop. Then I saw the experience and that he was a good student. Naturally, when I saw him against Mayweather, I saw a student against a professor in Floyd Mayweather. Floyd took him to school, but he learned from that.
So he got maturity. He was able to overcome defeat, because when he fought Mayweather, Canelo thought he was the king of the world, and he went to school with Floyd.
Yes.
And then he had the maturity to overcome that and learn and become a mature fighter.
Mauricio, that was the most important thing that took place with Alvarez, because losing, no one wants to lose, but when you lose to one of the best and you learn from that, you will become a better fighter, a better champion.
I would like to show you a few pictures from some events that were very special. We're going to start with one where Farrah Fawcett and Ryan O'Neal went to a homage that the WBC, my father, prepared for you in Washington. Do you remember that night?
Let me see it. I do remember, but let me see it.
Victor, la de Farrah Fawcett, por favor.
Oh my God.
Farrah Fawcett with Ryan O'Neal. That was in the 80s sometime.
Early 80s.
Early 80s, right.
Oh my gosh.
And then we have one at the Beverly Wilshire. Poner el de Beverly Wilshire, por favor.
Those were memories, man. Those are so incredible.
1983 or 84, there was a big homage for Muhammad Ali at the Beverly Wilshire Hotel.
Right.
And there's a great picture that we're going to put in one moment that you are with, let's see. Okay, right there.
Gosh. I got to have this picture. Sugar Ray Robinson. Look at that. Oh, my God. Marvin.
Ken Norton, Muhammad Ali, Bo Derek,
yeah. Where's my hand, my left hand?
Thank God it's on top on the shoulder. You can see right there.
It was a wonderful, incredible, just special moment, evening.
You know, that night, $200,000 were raised.
Wow.
For the UCLA research, for brain research that the WBC and UCLA made a partnership to find many different studies that were funded. And That money and that research led to the WBC to reduce from 15 to 12 rounds, to change the day of the weigh-in from the day of the fight to a day before, and countless different measures. You fought at 15 rounds. Is there something that you can tell about fighting 15 rounds to those who now fight 12 rounds?
The difference between going 12 rounds and going 15 rounds is boys to men. It's those, that additional three rounds. In fact, I almost relied upon those late rounds because I came on strong. I'm all for what's best, what's healthiest for the fighter, for the fighters. I don't care if it's 20 rounds, whatever's best for the fighters.
Yeah, those 13, 14, 15, the UCLA came out with a formula where you put dehydration plus fatigue plus a solid blow equals a mortal injury. And that's the reasoning behind reducing fatigue and dehydration, because the less you fight, the less those things occur. We have another picture. It was a award ceremony when you were with Mike Tyson and Sugar Ray, Junko Chang. Victor, ¿tienes la foto esta de Nueva York?
Estamos buscándola.
Okay. Y después, before we put this picture, tell us about your relationship with Nelson Mandela.
Oh my God. This was back in the 80s. I went to South Africa to do a motivational speech, and on this huge yacht ship. And when I got back to my hotel, I got a call that Nelson Mandela wanted me. He was there at the speech on the boat, and he wanted me to have dinner, come to his house for dinner that evening. And I got to his house. I was, again, shaking. I was so nervous. And he opened the door and he hugged me. He said, my champion. He said, one thing I don't tolerate is people being late. I just started sweating. Mauricio, I started sweating so bad. And he said, my photographer should have been here a long time ago. I'm like, oh my gosh, this is not fair. And I just found out then that he was an amateur boxer.
Yes.
He was a boxer. And we took pictures, and oh my gosh, he was my champ.
You had dinner at Nelson Mandela's home.
Yes. I kept saying, how can I put this in perspective? I mean, how can I see the unreal? And it was so amazing. One of my best moments.
He must have been an unbelievable sharing his experience. He just had that energy, huh?
Yes, he was a fighter inside out, and he fought for people's rights. He didn't care. He sacrificed himself for the right thing to do with his people.
Yes, unbelievable. And let me show you, I had here something. I found it when I started looking at my things. Oh, let's see this picture. This one, the one I was telling you, it was the awards ceremony, I believe, 88, 89. So Junko Chang from Korea, Chavez, my father, Mike. Yourself, and Donny Lalonde. Chavez, I talked to him. We had a WBC talks with Chavez today. Oh, he thought you were going to be together with him. He was so excited. He expressed like no one about you. He really loves, and he asked us to make sure that you know that Julio loves you. Let me show you one of the greatest memories I have in life. This picture you gave to me when you came to my house.
I was going to say to your house, yes. I remember that. What year was that? When was that?
I guess it was either 1979 or 1980.
80 sounds better.
I think you came after the first Duran fight. You came to Mexico. Yes. And you went to my house.
Yes.
And just to have here to Mauricio, my amigo. This is one of my
moments. My God. That's, and I meant that.
And you know, I remember you were wearing a t-shirt. So you're walking next to my father. I'm looking at you like a god. So I go and I touch your arm, and you just go like this. I could tell my friends the next day I was like in heaven. So how about Muhammad Ali? What would you like to share about Muhammad Ali? Because there's so many moments. We're gonna put a few pictures of your relationship with Ali, and there's so much love in the images, so much respect, so much. I would like you to hear from you about Muhammad Ali.
Muhammad Ali was more than my idol. He was my friend, and I remember one time he met my wife, and he said, "Let's have dinner." And we went to dinner, and he was doing magic tricks back then. He was such an inspiration to me. I remember vividly prior to fighting Tommy Hearns, I was in the ring, and I looked around the audience. I said, "Who in here can beat Tommy Hearns?" And I picked out Muhammad Ali. So if you go back to that fight, the first round, watch the way I was boxing. I was boxing like Muhammad Ali, using the ring, using my speed. And I got under Tommy's skin for a second. But Muhammad gave me so much advice. He always said, you know, Ray, sign your own checks. Always train hard. Don't take anyone for granted. He just gave me incredible advice. He was like my big brother. He was so special to me. And Sugar Ray Robinson here, oh my gosh, and Ali.
Yeah, these are, you must have such amazing memories on things.
These are moments I will cherish and maintain for forever.
A referee between Robinson and Ali, the greatest of them all.
That was amazing. Both of these, my champions, my idols.
And I wanted to take just a moment to simply thank you, because you gave my father an inspiration. You were my father's inspiration, and through your performance, you solidified his decisions. I don't know if I'm making sense of what I'm saying, especially on the